everybody, my name is Jose Andres, and I'm so humble and excited to be able to speak to so many of you food fighters of the world. And I think by now you all realize that your mission, in case you were not aware, is more important now than ever. There's many people that maybe we will never know that depend on us to come not only with the right ideas, but with boots on the ground to put those ideas up and working on behalf of the millions that sometimes, as we know, don't know what they're gonna be feeding their children every single day. And this conference, Food Waste, it's a very important one. We all know that we produce food out of the goodness of the earth, enough to be feeding absolutely everybody. And we understand the many challenges. The books of theory are full of reasons of the things we don't do and the things we should do. And then we know that sometimes it's very difficult to put those theories up and working on the fields, on the communities, with the very simple mission of feeding every single kid, every single woman that may be hungry. At Ball Central Kitchen, the NGO we founded right after the earthquake in Port-au-Prince over 10 years ago, we knew one thing, that cooks like me, we feed the few, but we could be part of feeding the many. And when I began going to different parts of America and then of the world, in the early days of an emergency where the catastrophe was creating a humanitarian crisis and where sometimes food in the early days could be almost an afterthought, I realized that I could be putting together this very quick response team where always using local resources and local talent, we could be activating cooks and restaurants and farmers to accomplish the one very simple thing of providing a meal in a moment of mayhem. I learned that while we talk about food waste, the number one thing in emergencies we can never forget is wasting time. And even if it's not an emergency, we need to take every day that we have one children without food as an emergency. So the urgency of now is yesterday. We must work quicker. We must put ideas. 21st century is the time for bold ideas. Bold ideas that will give us hope of ending hunger in the years to come. And as I'm saying that food waste is attached to time waste, we can not but remember that in emergencies, Wall Central Kitchen always tries to make sure that when we go, like in places like Guatemala, we buy from local farmers after the volcano exploded around Escuintla. By doing that and not bringing non-perishable foods from other parts of the country or of the world, we are already, without wasting time, empowering the local economies, the local farmers, the rural areas, hiring local, and having as much as we can, even we as Ball Central Kitchen come with a team from the outside, empower the locals to feed the locals. In this process, every dollar we put into an emergency is not money wasted, but money invested. Every dollar is multiplied by three or four by obviously feeding people in need, but also putting farmers in the right path for success and also creating local jobs that gives hope that even after a catastrophe, things can be better, quicker, rather than later. And on food waste, I will tell you that I always thought that we need to sometimes understand that what we are doing is not really wasting food. What we are actually doing is wasting people's lives. by fighting food waste, we're making sure that every single human, every single child, every single woman will not be wasting their lives by having to be working long hours every single day sometimes just to bring water to the table, or by going to a forest to pick up wood because they are too poor to buy any other form of energy to cook the energy. At the end, being poor is expensive. At the end, being poor and being hungry is a question. Is the energy you put out versus the energy you bring in? When people have to put so much energy out, used to be at ground zero and feeding themselves and their family, and some days they end the day negative, they are hungry and they are poor. And that's why food waste plays such a very important role. By not having food waste, we are making sure that we are not wasting any energy and that we are providing good energy to the people. I do believe that when we go in emergencies, I learn that the urgency of now is yesterday. And this is how we should be dealing with this issue. And when I speak about yesterday, it means also about the lessons learned in the past, going to centuries. Humans, we've learned amazing methods of preserving foods, from covering food in salt, or pickling, or canning, or many other methods that have given humans the amazing tools of food preservation. I know that we are trying, but we must try harder. Sometimes we know we're in communities that they have a more or less good harvest, but because lack of refrigeration or lack of know-how or methods of preservation, those food go to waste. That's why education in the way of preserving foods is gonna have to be key in the 21st century. We must bring back the know-how of preserving foods to every single community in the world. We know we can do whatever we want with the goodness of the earth, that we are smart enough to produce food, but we need to make sure that all this know-how is shared with every single community. People don't want our pity. People want our respect. And the way to give them respect is being next to them in emergencies, but also being next to them until they are able to produce food for their communities, to make a living out of working the fields, to make sure that they will have enough food, not only to eat, but enough food also to sell in markets. At the end, achieving a perfect 360-degree, almost three-dimensional economic system where lift up everybody. Let's make sure that once again, in the process of not wasting food anymore, you and I agree that we cannot waste any more time. And more important, we should never again waste the life of any one person. I think together we can do it. Let's aim high and let's make sure that food waste one day will be words of the past, to hopefully dream of a better tomorrow. Thank you.